baby beluga in the deep blue sea. Swim so wild and you swim so free. Heaven above and the sea below, and a little white whale on the go.
Good morning, baby belugas, and happy Monday. It's a brand new week and a new month. Let's say our daily pledge all together. Today is a new day. I am ready to be the best me I can be. I will listen so I can learn. I will try hard so my brain can grow. I will not give up. I can learn anything I put my mind to. I will show respect for people, respect for our school, respect for myself. It is my day to make great, so let's make it a great day. Remember, that also means that we are showing respect to our homes that have turned into our classrooms, to our technology at home, and to the grown-ups at home with us. Okay, heading over to our morning message. Read it with me, boys and girls. Today is Monday, May 4th, 2020. Today, I am thankful for fun computer programs. We will start using boom cards today. I can't wait. Can you? Boys and girls, a few things to do. We know the drill. At the top, putting my abbreviated date, 5-4-20. It is May 4th, 2020, a new month with a new number. Now, Ms. Bardell said what she is thankful for. Quickly write down what you are thankful for, and remember, if you need a second, press your pause button. Now, today I said I was thankful for computer programs, and I told you we will start using a program called Boom Cards. And boys and girls, it is so much fun. This is how we're going to be doing our math, our reading, and our science this week. I hope you like it as much as I do. Now, before we move to our story today, I circled a contraction in my morning message. Contractions have something called an apostrophe, and they represent two words. Can't is the same as what two words, boys and girls? That's right, can not. So, I cannot wait. Can you? Boys and girls, I would like to point out how I used all three end marks in my writing today, and I would like you to challenge yourselves to do that with your writing. I included a sentence with a period, an exclamation mark, and a question mark. It gives some variety to my writing. Great, let's go to our story. It's called Hello Moon. Hello Moon. And this story was written by Francesca Simon Bencourt. Hello Moon, can we talk? I get lonely down here sometimes. What I want to know is, do you have a bouncy bed? I like bouncing on my bed. Do you go to the park, Moon? I like going down the twisty-turny slide. Do you like chocolate ice cream? That's my favorite food. Do you pretend you're a crocodile? Do you play pirates? So do I. What else do you do? Boys and girls, check out the moon playing pirates with our main character. He has a great imagination. Do you like animals, Moon? I really like tigers. Can you see everything, Moon? Can you see the city? Can you see the sea? Can you see under the sea? Can you see the highest mountain? What gorgeous illustrations, boys and girls. I love what they did with the story. Can you see the whole wide world? Oh, show me, show me. Boys and girls, thumbs up or thumbs down? Do you think the moon can see the whole wide world? Do you have lots of friends, Moon? A billion, trillion, gazillion? But they're all so far away. Can you tell me some of their names? Leo, Milky Way, Pegasus, Little Bear. What are those, boys and girls? Sometimes it's hard to fall asleep. Do you get lonely up there, Moon? Don't be lonely. I'm here anytime you want to talk. Good night, Moon. Boys and girls, we had a main character in our story. That's right, the boy, and he was having a chat with the moon. Our main character, the boy, changed a bit in our story. How was he feeling at the beginning of the story? Let's find some evidence. That's right. He was feeling a little lonely, maybe a bit bored. But he had a great conversation with the moon. And by the end, how was he feeling? That's right. He was feeling happy. I can see a smile on his face. He was happy enough to finally fall asleep, and it looks like the moon was happy too. That was a good one, boys and girls. Let's go ahead and go to our story wheel and give it a spin. Keep your papers nearby. We might need to do some writing. Ooh, tell me an important detail in the story. Something about the boy and the moon's conversation. You can just whisper this one to your computer screens. Good, let's just do one more spin this morning. Oh, Miss Bardell got the same one. Let's spin again. Good, how did the story end? We talked a bit about this, boys and girls. Draw me a quick picture or write on your paper. How did our story end today? Great job. Let's head into our math for this morning. And as we go, I want you to cub along with me. Are you ready? In June, oh, I see a month. I can tell that the author used an uppercase letter at the beginning of their month. Good job. In June, I built 2 houses. In July, I built 6 houses. In August, I built 5 houses. How many houses did I build? Boys and girls, I spy 3 add-ins. We are getting so good at this, but it is a bit tricky, so let's take it nice and slow. Starting with my first add-end or part, my 2 houses. Good. Those were the 2 I built in June. Here are my 6. From July. And my last part or addend are the 5 houses I built in August. I was pretty busy, boys and girls. Now, when we learned about even and odd numbers, I taught you a bit of a trick to make some buddies. So this one has a buddy, 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 this one has a buddy. This one does not have a buddy. So that tells me right away, will my sum be even or odd? That's right, it will be odd because this house does not have a buddy. Let's build our number sentence super duper carefully. 2 + 6 + 5 equals what? Let's count them by twos, starting with our buddies. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. And one more will make, good, 13. A 1 and a 3. Make sure you do not have this on your paper, boys and girls. Or this. Wah, wah. Miss Bardell is still seeing some of those reversals. So before you finish any assignment, I want you to double check and say, is anything looking in the mirror? If it is, we know we can just flip it around. It's an easy fix, boys and girls. I hope you have a wonderful, wonderful Monday. I miss you. Bye, belugas. Keep working hard.
Baby beluga, baby beluga. Is the water warm? Is your mama home with you? So happy.